it's snack time again at the classroom, and today I found a whole bunch of different kinds of rice crackers again, and I really wanted to try them. So here they are. Okay, so quite a famous and popular cracker in Japan, Happy Tang. And I think I bought the regular kind, maybe I didn't. The regular kind is, has a little bit of powder on it, kind of sweet kind of powder, and it's very popular. But they had a new kind called Cheese Choitashi Shoyu Koku Uma Wafu Cheese Aji. There you go. And what it is it's a cheese with a little bit of soy sauce taste. I thought that was kind of interesting. So, I bought one of those. And then, I got, ta-da, another kind of happy tang. This is called Otona no Lemon Pepper Aji, which is a lemon pepper taste for adults. Yay. So, that looked really interesting. Okay, so there you go. Next. There you go. Nori shio goma yu or goma abura fumi, which is nori, which is a soy seaweed, plus salt, plus goma abura, which is sesame oil taste, which is really interesting as well. This nori shio is very simple, and I think I've introduced it before. Well-used type of seasoning, but this sesame oil is kind of new. So in Japan, we use a lot of sesame oil for seasoning, just a little bit in things, just to get the taste of sesame. So this will be interesting. And look at this. Kodawari no wasabi age. So this obviously has wasabi in it, which is a kind of Japanese horseradish, green horseradish used in sashimi and sushi. Okay, otsumami snack. I'm going to start with the cheese choitashi shoyu. Aji. Oishisa no saihakken. So, shinhakken. Okay, and this is seasonal. So, it's only out for a limited time only. And here are the happy tang. This is what they always look like. They always have a little bit of powder on them. But this time, the powder tastes like a little bit of soy sauce with cheese. I'm already drooling. Okay, here we go. Oh yeah. Sweet kind of cheese taste with soy sauce. Really good. The powder on the cracker kind of gives it very nice seasoning. I think the cracker itself has a cheese in it. There's little dots of cheese. So, but the powder is really good. Soy sauce cheese. Very creamy, buttery kind of. I think it would be butter unless it had actually said cheese. Bata shoyu is quite a popular taste in Japan. Butter with soy sauce. Some people eat rice with butter and soy sauce mixed into it. Definitely recommend you trying it. Just a little spoonful of rice and spoonful of butter and a little bit of soy sauce mixed into the rice. Very nice. But anyway, so this cheese soy sauce is very similar in taste to that. Yay. Okay, next. 大人のレモンペッパー。 And this lemon powder is from 瀬戸内さん。 Which is 瀬戸内? Which is a place in Japan famous for its lemons. So they use the powder from lemons got in at this place. This is also limited time only. Okay, let me try it. Well, these are smaller. Oh, I can smell the pepper too. Very strong pepper taste. Smell. With the kind of a lemony kind of, it's really interesting kind of smell. Not sour. Kind of lemonade kind of, or lemon marmalade kind of taste. But it has a little bit of bitter taste to it, like a marmalade, like you're eating the skin. And a little bit of peppery taste too. It's pretty good. It's a lemony kind of taste all through your mouth. Interesting. So many different kinds of senbei. Happitan is one of the very popular ones. You really can't stop once you start, you know. I was going to show you the inside. Nothing inside. A lemon taste. This one's really strong. The powder. There's a bunch of powder on there. Strong taste of lemon. That's interesting. Yeah. I think this size is perfect. I wouldn't want to eat a whole huge bag of them, but it's good. Okay. Let's try these. Nori shio goma abura. I want to see what the sesame oil does to the senbei. Because nori shio is so simple. Oh, now this is not a hapitan, so it looks a little bit different, but it still has powder all over it. Here we go. And it really smells like sesame oil. Sesame. Now, you're using a famous sesame oil in Japan. This is quite popular and famous in Japan. I use it in my kitchen. As the other ones. Good. It's more the scent of sesame oil than the actual taste of it. I can taste the seaweed as well. Okay, so next, this is a little bit more scary. Wasabi age, which means, you know, it's going to be pretty hot, maybe. Let's see. Fried, deep fried. Otsumami snack. So they're used to eat with beer or sake, maybe. Oh. I think a it just burnt my tongue. That's pretty hot. I did. I feel like I burnt my tongue. As long as it's, wow, that's pretty hot. The sundae itself is pretty good. It's just a fried cracker. We got this wasabi taste, which is pretty strong, actually. It's supposed to have peanuts in it, too. I can't see any. They're probably at the very bottom. I'd have to put them in a plate or something. No, I think my son might enjoy this. Hot. Yeah. Very hot. Well, not very hot, but my tongue is tingling from that. I think it's hotter than the regular. Well, could be hotter than regular wasabi. They've made it especially hot, especially, if, you know, so it tastes good with beer or whatever. Okay, so those were the four kinds of senbei that I just wanted to try with you guys. I think among them all, I liked the hapitan best. Yeah, probably I like cheese and the shoyu hapitan. It's very simple and enjoyable. The lemon pepper was okay too, but I think I like this one the best. Anyway.